Now we're going to talk about how to find the input impedance of a transmission line when you know its length, L, and you know its load, ZL. And you also need to know its characteristic impedance, Z0. Let's say that ZL is 100 plus J 100 ohms, and that the characteristic impedance is 50 ohms. So in order to plot this on the Smith chart, I'm going to take my load and divide it by my characteristic impedance, which gives me 2 plus J2. Let's plot it. Here's the circle with the real part of 2, and here is the imaginary circle with the real part plus 2. So right there is my load impedance. And I want to be able to find my input impedance, Zn, when my length is 0.2 wavelengths. The way I do that is I plot my load as I have here, and then I'm going to use my distance axis. To use the distance axis, draw a straight line from the center of the Smith chart out here to the outside of the Smith chart. Go through this point. Kind of missed it, but, you know, pretty close. A little hard on a tablet PC. The line that I'm going to be using to measure distance is going to be on the very outside of the Smith chart. If I want to go from my load in this direction to the input impedance, that is towards the generator. The generator is over here. So I'm going to come to this outside axis where it says wavelengths toward the generator, and it tells me it goes in this direction. So this axis right here is the one that I'm going to be reading. Right along there. Now it does not matter exactly where I begin on this outside axis. What matters is the relative distance between two points. Here's the point that I'm starting with right here. I'm going to kind of put a little "you are here" point. So right there, there's my "you are here" point. And that's at the load, and I'm going to move towards the generator 0.2 wavelengths. So first, I'm going to read this value, which is 0.21, and then I'm going to add 0.2 wavelengths. So I want to come over here, go in this direction, remember that's towards the generator, until I get to 0.41. Here's 0.38, 0.39, 0.4. Right there is 0.41 wavelengths. That is 0.21 plus 0.2 wavelengths. So now I'm going to draw another straight line from the center of my Smith chart out to this distance point. And I'm also going to measure the distance, the magnitude right there, same way I have from the beginning, except I'm going to put it on this axis. It's going to go from the center, always start at the center, right to here. So I rotated 0.2 wavelengths, that's L, towards the generator, and that brought me to my input impedance. Let's read its real and imaginary parts. So the input impedance has a real part right here of about 0.35. The imaginary part is negative because I'm below this axis, negative J, and let's read the imaginary part, which is right here. Looks like that's 0.6. This is not in ohms. This is a normalized value. So to get it in ohms, I denormalize by multiplying by Z0. So that gives me 17.5 minus J 30 ohms. Now what if instead of finding the input impedance, I wanted to start at the input and find the load impedance? That's the topic of our next video.